If you're not already standing, just stand up and wave to him. I'm talking about Colonel Charles McGee, a real-life hero from Cleveland, Ohio. He lives out in Maryland here now. But Charles McGee, one of the original Tuskegee Airmen, he flew his airplane just like this, down there in Tuskegee, Alabama. Then went on, as we said, 409 combat missions. And his buddy's here with me. He drove him in this morning. Tell me about your name.
He drove himself in.
Well, that's just how he does, isn't it?
Yeah, Vincent Nickens.
Vincent, we're glad you're here. You and Colonel McGee have been hanging out down there. Look at this Brad down there. Brad Lang, the son of Tuskegee Airman. Down there in the Mustang, the Colonel Charles McGee in the steering. What is historic about this is that he flew in, didn't he, at one point with these steering.
Yes.
Down in Tuskegee, where he trained as a pilot. Isn't that remarkable?
It is.
And he is on the people.
Exact same plane.
Isn't that incredible?
1941 steering.
That is so cool to see. And he's up front, if I remember right. Is he up front? You can see he's actually riding then in the student position, the same seat that he would have flown.
Exactly.
And we're commemorating this here today. Give Colonel McGee a big wave. Now, the movie Rise Above actually features his story along with everyone else's. So you gotta go see the movie Rise Above that Colonel McGee is part of. Now he flew in all three wars, including Vietnam. He was in F-4.
Yes.
Flew that big
fight. That's what he flew in Vietnam.
You know, we were hanging out one day. I've said it publicly with my wife, who was an active duty Air Force member, was walking through the Pentagon one day. I just finished interviewing her with Oshkosh, did a big thing on stage. Talked to my Vegas a time or two with our other events we do, where we host and interview these guys. And he was just sitting on a little bench in the Pentagon. He said, "Oh my God, Colonel McGee, how are you?" And he was like, "Drove in today to see somebody." I don't remember what he was there. He drove himself to the Pentagon, though. 90-something years old, just sitting there in the hallways. Most unassuming man you'd ever meet in your life. Am I wrong about that?
Very easy.
And think of what he's doing.
It's absolutely amazing.
It really is.
That's one of the great things about him. He just knows that the service that he's done for his country, that's what he did. And he didn't even train any other way. So he doesn't see himself up here. But we all know.
And that's the truth. And on so many levels, right?
On so many levels.
Now, do you hear yourself fly to see that?
I do. I fly off since I was 16.
And what does it mean to you? To grow up on this plane that just came here?
You know, no doubt about being one of my first successes. But I'm not honored to be one of those.
Above